Hey everyone, my name is Dorian and I'm here with Shuffle and Chill. Today I'm going to show you guys Accelgor. It's a new stage. Well, it's not new, it's a repeat stage that got dropped on February 12th. So it's basically our Valentine Day update. It's here for 7 days. It's one heart to try. You guys should do it. It's got a great ability, Eject Plus Plus. And it's not too hard to beat. I think some people can farm it. This that you're looking at is my failed run. Basically, I tried just bringing an optimized team and then tweaked a few things. I put Carbink there for the Mega Boost Plus because I thought I'd make the Aerodactyl go off faster. My Aerodactyl is pretty weak. It's not skill swapped. It doesn't have swap plus plus. And yeah, basically the strategy did not work out. Lugia is obviously there for the Eject Plus. That's a perfect TC swapped Hoopa. So I thought I'd start off some combos with Hoopa and then, you know, get some big damage bursts with Aerodactyl. But the problem with Aerodactyl is after you remove all the unbreakable blocks, he's pretty useless and he's just kind of sitting there. So I decided to change things up. Here are my recommendations if you guys are going to try this. Bring Mega Tyranitar if you need to make it go off or become live faster. Use something like Winking Carbink. I think Relicanth also has Mega Boost Mega Boost. It doesn't have Mega Boost Plus. I brought Gigalith. I recommend something with a Block Smash Plus or something that Block Smashes to get some room at the beginning of the game if you are planning on doing it without items. You can't always Mega Start your Tyranitar or your Tapper, doesn't even have to be Mega Tyranitar, to clear up that messy board at the beginning of the game. It doesn't have a ton of HP. I would say bring something that can boost up your combos. I brought Lycanroc. You can do something with Typeless Combo. Typeless Combo is also great, and it will allow you to bring some other Pokemon along that aren't super effective and make them deal some good damage. So at the beginning of this run, basically my goal was to get Mega Tyranitar on. I got very few Carbink on the board, so I couldn't really tap into that Mega Boost Plus. I ended up making a whole bunch of just like filler moves, just hoping that Tyranitar's Crushing Step would go off. And eventually I had to wipe the board. But so the Gigalith is meant to give you room at the beginning of the game before your Tyranitar becomes live. I think I've said that already, but you ideally want to match the Winking Carbink because this is what will get your Tyranitar online as fast as possible. I did not have a very good run, to be honest with you guys. I got lucky on a couple of Skyfall matches. I believe this is it. Basically, at this point, it's got more than half of the HP, and I only have 3 moves left. So I was already thinking this is not going to happen. But once Tyranitar comes online, you're able to extend your combos really well. If you can lead off with Lycanroc and get some matches, it's really, really sweet. It doesn't have to be Lycanroc. It can be, you know, if it's a flying team, something that boosts the attack, the damage that flying Pokemon do in a combo. And you'll be able to clear the stage pretty easily. Now, if you want to catch it, I would probably recommend a Mega Start. And just be ready to commit that that Great Ball. But yeah, anyways, that was my guide for this. If you guys liked what you saw, if you have any comments, please leave a comment in the comment section. If you like what you saw, go ahead and subscribe. I'll be uploading more from this week's update. Yeah, see you guys next time.